I wanted to talk a little bit about image filtering. Right, we had a video on image filtering a while ago on Gaussian blurs and mean blurs and this kind of thing. But remember, we talked about convolutions, and convolutions are actually used in a lot of places. So Sobel operator for edge detection, but also in deep networks. So deep networks have convolutions in as well. So a huge problem with something like a Gaussian blur is, let's suppose we want to do a really big one. Right? We want to do a huge blur to really blur out an image.
So you're talking about increasing the size of the kernel?
That's right. The radius of the Gaussian and the size of the window that we're sliding across is going to get much, much bigger. Suppose you want to do even a relatively small standard deviation, you're going to have a very, very large window that you're sliding across doing your convolution. That's going to get slow really, really quickly. Let's remind ourselves very briefly what a convolution is. So let's suppose you have an image, which is a grid. I've always had bad luck drawing grids in Computerphile videos. They never come out parallel. I've seen ones. Right, and we have something called a kernel, right, which is our filter that we're passing over this image. So let's say we've got a very simple one, which is our Sobel filter, or our Gaussian filter, which is a 3x3. Now what we do on our image, let's put the bounds on, there we go, is we place this kernel over here, over the top three, and we do a sum product. So we do the multiple of this one and this one, plus this one and this one, plus this one times this one, plus this one times this one, plus this one times this one, and so on. And now for a 3x3 operator, that's gonna be pretty quick, right? You could write this in C or something like that. It's gonna go really, really quickly. And that's broadly speaking what a deep network does. It just does it lots and lots of times. The problem is that suppose we want to do like a big Gaussian blur or a really large window, this is going to get slow really, really quickly, because for every position in this image, we're doing 9 products and then adding them all up. If this window is 10 by 10 or 20 by 20 or 100 by 100, the amount of operations per pixel is going to get really quite large. And we're talking minutes to hours to just pass over this image. And yet the thing is, if you go into Photoshop or you go into an image processing package and you perform a really, really large blur, it doesn't take minutes or hours, right? Because that's not acceptable. It goes very, very quickly. And so what they're doing really is cheating, right? Kind of. What we're gonna do is we're gonna turn this kernel into an identical one in two passes, where we have a 1x3 and then a 3x1, like that. And what we're saying is, if we convolve our image first by this one and then by this one, we get the exact same product as we would have got if we just did it with the 3x3. And we've only used 6 values. And that's going to get better and better the larger and larger your kernel goes. Okay, so hang on a minute. Right. The first thing to note is we can't just have any, you know, n by n filter and decompose it into 2 1x n filters and it definitely work, right? We have to make sure that the process of doing horizontal followed by vertical or vice versa is going to perform the exact same operation as the original combined filter. And really, this is a simple matrix multiplication. So you've got a situation where you want this matrix here, however big it is, to be this one times by this one, which means that if you convolve any image with these two, you're actually doing it with this. Is the long and short of it. Now, that isn't true of every filter. It's true of a Sobel. You can split Sobel up. And it's true of Gaussians, and it's true of mean box blurs, and so on. But it's not true of any kernel you wanted to use, right? Which is kind of relevant to deep learning, but perhaps I'll mention that at the end. So how does this work? Well, let's imagine that we're convolving a pixel with this horizontal blur, right? So we've got our image, right, which is going to be something like this. So you can also convolve using fast Fourier transforms. So that's another time. Actually, that is another time because that's really fast.
Is that why it's called fast?
Right, so let's imagine we're looking at this pixel here. Now what we would normally do is we'd sort of put our 3x3 kernel over here and we'd do this sum product, right? But what we're going to do first is the horizontal pass. So actually we're going to do it over this one. This pixel here is going to include this one and it's going to include this one. Right, sometimes in graphics they call this a gather. In this one and this one and this one and this one. So this is going to be calculated using these 3 pixels. This one is going to be calculated using these 3 pixels. This one's going to be calculated using these 3 pixels. And that means that when we finally do our vertical pass here, we're actually bringing this pixel in here like this. And you can see we've brought information from these 4 pixels, which we haven't otherwise done. We haven't actually looked at those pixels with respect to here, but actually we've got that information and we've saved a bit of time. Right. If you've got an n by n kernel, then the number of operations you're going to need to do for a square kernel is going to be n squared. It's going to be 2n for a vertical followed by a horizontal pass. I've coded this up, and let's see how much faster it is. We need a computer. Where did I put it? I started writing some Python code that I'm going to release the code, right? So I tried to make it as, you know, simple as possible. So there are libraries in Python to do this, like OpenCV, right? And they'll probably do it faster than my code. I wasn't really interested in how fast it was, apart from a comparison, right? And I also wanted people to be able to see how it works. So what I've done is I've implemented it in Python, but it was too slow, because Python is not really suitable for, you know, low-level pixel manipulations. So what I did was I then used Cython to compile this Python into C, and that's much, much faster. So if you want to look at the code, we'll put a link in the description. So essentially, this is very, very simple. We load an image up, we turn it into an array, and then we pass it off to Cython, which does a convolution with any kernel that we provide, and then returns a response. Right? And at the moment, what it's doing is it's doing a 2D Gaussian blur over quite a large image. So I've got this image that I took this morning of a section of my Christmas tree. So, you know, that looks like many other people's Christmas trees. There's a bauble on it. Too many baubles, actually. And at the moment, it's relatively sharp, right? But let's imagine we want to blur this image. I'm going to blur it with a two-dimensional Gaussian of size 10, right? So that's a standard deviation of 10. The radius is going to be somewhere around 60 pixels, something like that, right, to cover for the entire range of the Gaussian. So let's run that now. So I've already compiled the Python into C and the C into, anyway. So this is quite a large image. I think it's something like 16 megapixels or 20 megapixels or somewhere, I don't know. I'm running on one of our servers, not that it really matters. It's gonna take quite a long time because for every pixel in our image, we're looking at a 60 by 60 window. Right?
So this is the long form.
This is the long 2D version, right? Which is why it's taking so long. In fact, we might wanna go and get a coffee.
It's not dependent on what those pixels are, it's just...
It doesn't matter about what the pixels are, the operations per pixel are the same. Obviously it matters a little bit what the size of the image is. It's still going. I mean, we could work out roughly how many operations this has to do, but it's a lot. I mean, it's hard to know exactly how many it does, because there are also bounds checks and things like this. Not all the time, but some of the time.
So we could probably just say at least this many.
Yeah. Oh, it's still going. It's still going. It must have been, yeah.
Is this a fast server doing this work as well?
It's a fast server, yeah, with two cores. It's not multi-threaded though. GPUs would do this really, really quickly, but you still shouldn't be doing 2D convolutions like this because it's incredibly slow. So it's 4912 pixels by 3264, which is 16 megapixels. And for each megapixel, so for each pixel, it's gonna do about 60 squared operations. So times 60 times 60. Oh, it's quite a lot of operations actually. It's 57 billion, right? And that's without the bounds checking and all the other business it has to do. Oh, it's finished. It took 189 seconds.
Does it look impressive?
Well, let's see. It won't, no, it'll be, I mean, can you imagine if you had to wait this long to do anything in Photoshop? It would just be really bad news. So let's have a quick look then. Here's my output image. And you can see we've managed to obtain a slight blur. Right, because the standard deviation of 10 on a 16 megapixel image is not actually that much. You're going to need to do a standard deviation of into the sort of dozens before you start to notice a real serious blur. The complexity of this problem is n squared. Even increasing the standard deviation by a few more will massively increase the amount of time it takes. So let's see if we can improve things. So I'm going to remove that code, and I'm going to instead run it in two passes. So instead of going from the image to the output, I go from the original image, I do an n by one convolution, into an intermediate image, and then I convolve that with the vertical version into the final image. So it's two convolutions, but it won't take double the time. So let's run it. Still a pretty big image. So the original one took 189 seconds. 8 seconds, pretty good. But 8 seconds is now into the point where you could, as long as you had some progress bar or something like that, people aren't gonna get too annoyed about it, right? So let's increase the standard deviation of this. Let's do a little bit more of an epic blur. So 45. In my code, a kernel of standard deviation 45 requires a window size or kernel size of 271. So for every pixel, it would be doing 271 squared operations. No. So let's just do a single 271 by one and then a one by 271. All right, so let's run that, see how long it takes. This will take longer than 8 seconds because it's much bigger than 10, but not a huge amount longer, right? It goes up a little bit with n rather than squaring. I'm going to guess, all right, so quiz, I think 21 seconds.
Go for 18.
Okay. I have no, you know, I'm basing this on nothing but random guesswork. That seems plausible.
I might go higher.
Yeah, how long has it been now?
I'll be able to time it afterwards.
Of course, you don't know when it's going to appear on my screen. I could go, ah.
Yeah, I'll know afterwards.
That took 36 seconds. So not too bad, right? That's a very large, if you look at the actual blur itself, I mean, you can't see anything anymore.
No, it just looks like my camera work. What are you drinking today?
For my sins, eggnog latte. Just once per year, otherwise, just a special treat near the end of the year.